Hey David, this is David Kwon. So I am you, but I'm a lot older. I'm not that much older. You're 21. I'm 25 now, almost 26 actually. So it's pretty interesting that you're a very recent version of me. Fair to say. Now I see that we share a lot of similarities between each other. You definitely become more and more like me as you grow up, which, it makes sense. But it's still really striking that it takes you this long, takes me this long to have this turning point in my life. When you're 21 is when you finally decide to kind of abandon or change your lifestyle in a whole new way. You adopt a lifestyle that really changes almost a great part of great amount of aspects of your life. What you eat, how you eat, what you dress, all those things. It's a really drastic change. It's a humongous turning point in your life, and it happens when you're 21. And I think it was a long time coming. I wouldn't say you always felt this way, but for a long, long, long time, this concept of killing another living being and consuming the meat of that murder, eating that so that you can continue living yourself, this concept bothered you since you were, I don't know, a long time, since you were like 14 or 15 or maybe sometimes even when you were a kid. The concept of eating meat is something that really, really, really bothered you, made you feel really, really guilty all the time. In fact, 2 years ago, when you're 19 years old, about 19, you actually make a YouTube video. I think maybe it's later, maybe when you're 20, I don't know, but you make a YouTube video and you upload it. And in it, you start talking about the fact that you want to become a vegetarian. I remember you're holding this chicken taco in your hand in front of a camera and talking about how guilty eating this makes you feel and that you want to become a vegetarian for the right ethical reason, but that you just don't see yourself being able to do so. Well, the good news is that you do become able to do so, and you decide that. March 29th, 2010 is the day I consider as like my rebirth, almost really. That's like my born again day. I don't remember the day in which I became a born again Christian. I'm assuming there was a day, but I don't know. It was at an earlier point in my life, but I didn't take a record of that. But March 29, 2013 is a day I do record. It is the very last day in which I consider myself able to justify meat eating. Or animal products for that matter. It's the very last day. I have my, I mean, I end up failing in my journey of veganism a good number of times, even after March 29, 2010. But that is the day in which I decide for myself that it is no longer okay for me to do so. It is not justifiable. It is unethical for me to eat animal meat. Just that part. So I become really, I just had this really vegetarian mindset that day. It's a profound moment in my life. It does happen. I think the guilt that you've felt from since you were like a te you know early teenager onwards and onwards, it accrues up until that point where you just it just you can no longer continue it anymore. The thought of you can't live with yourself and continue that. When you don't have to, when you have the capability to break from that lifestyle, and so that's what you choose to do. It's a you raise some interesting questions. It's not an easy thing for you at least, because you have you kind of again just like quitting smoking, you kind of go cold turkey, yeah, which may not have been the smartest thing to do because you really don't know anything about. How to be vegan. How to be vegan. You just give it up on like a very emotional thing. So, you becoming vegan is actually, or me becoming vegan is one of actually the most weirdest thing. It's one of the most inconsistent thing about my turning points. All my turning points in my life have been kind of, well, immigration to America was kind of forced on me, but it is something that I, you know, that I overcame through effort and will and all that. The turning point of, I guess, giving up on my Christian faith was a very logical process. It took years of going through this process. So it was a very logical decision. And then coming to New York City was another turning point in my life. Again, that was a very, very logical decision. I thought about a lot of what social work is, you know, of going to New York City. It was a thought process. Going vegan was not, ironically. It's one of those things that it makes the most sense to be logical. But it's not. It was an emotional thing. I had that. I was having a, you know, KFC, a bunch of chicken legs and breasts and stuff. And eating it, I felt so guilty that I just broke down crying in tears. And I said, I can no longer continue this because it makes me so feel that much guiltier. And I started reading that, you know, human body does not need animal products in order to thrive and to survive. In fact, it actually harms you. It is actually not healthy for you, but that's something that I didn't even know back then. I didn't have much knowledge about what becoming vegan meant. I just did it because of my emotional state at the time, which is crazy. I usually don't change my life around based on emotional impulses like that. But veganism is one thing that I ended up doing it because of that. And then I found, you know, the logical process afterwards. So it's interesting, you know, the first two months is pretty ridiculous. I go to Subway and order the veggie deluxe. I go to Chipotle and order veggie burritos. I make pizza without cheese. And those are actually really good. If I have the time, I would do that more often. Make my pizza-less cheese and cheese-less pizza. And my roommates, when I made it for them, my former roommates, they really enjoyed those. You become a better cook, actually. Becoming vegan really is a positive change for you. You cook more because you have to, because a lot of the things that you buy just aren't vegan. Almost everything that is packaged or processed is not vegan. They're not even vegetarian a lot of times. But yeah, that's one thing. You cook a lot more. You feel better about yourself. No more guilt, honestly. It's a very liberating experience. It's a healthier diet that you have. Much healthier diet. It's pretty ridiculous. Do you lose weight? No. I actually gain weight, believe it or not. You're ridiculously underweight now. And I'm still really underweight, but I'm definitely more of a normal weight range than before I turned vegan, surprisingly enough. There is this whole protein myth that goes floating around. You know, so, yeah. What did my parents think? That was another question you raised. It was hard for them to take at first, honestly. My dad was extremely disappointed. He wants the best for myself, and you know, he thinks not able to enjoy the taste of meat and all, you know, and one of his biggest wish for me was always to kind of not be so stick skinny. And to him, he was like, "Whoa, you know, this veganism will really turn you into a skeleton skinny person." So I think the biggest debate I've had with anyone about my veganism was my dad. I think there were about 3 sessions total, and each session lasted about like an hour and a half or 2 hours of me just talking with him and kind of having this debate. Good thing is I've had that debate later in my vegan journey and not in the beginning, because in the beginning I didn't really know anything about veganism. But by that point, after about 8 months of becoming vegan, I've had that dialogue with my dad, and it was interesting. With my mom, it was kind of tough, but my mom is actually really supportive. She's probably the first person in my life to become supportive of my veganism. She's actually vegetarian now, or pescatarian. She still occasionally eats fish, but you know, my my talking about it to her, you know, for health reasons, she doesn't do it for ethical reasons, which is me. I do it for ethical and environmental reasons. But for health reasons, she started realizing that, you know, being vegetarian is good for you, really good for you. So yeah, I didn't try that hard, but I was just trying to explain my situation and then the process, or why I turned out to be vegan. And in that process, my mom ended up being almost pretty much vegetarian, except she sometimes eats fish. Amazing thing. I think that's really amazing. But yeah, the toughest part for me was I had no support. I didn't know any friends who were even vegetarian. No support system in regards to having this turning point for me. In fact, I faced so much opposition. People who, when I went to my internship and I, you know, food comes up, you know, it's just like, hey, David, you know, you know, we're going to order some food from Dumpling Place. You want something? And I'm just like, oh, I can't really have anything because I decided to become vegan, which just totally raises red flags for a lot of people. So I've had to go through a lot of like, dude, don't be vegan, or giving me all these questions and that I didn't know the answer to, honestly, because I've just turned vegan without knowing what it meant. That's probably the toughest thing, the social aspect of things. When you're in a social gathering, and there's food and stuff to eat, food is very a cultural thing. There's nothing there that you can eat, oftentimes. And I had to refuse to eat that. I have to refuse and be like, I can't eat that. Because you know, I'm vegan. I can't eat that. Really disappoints a lot of people. Raises a lot of eyebrows. So that's the social aspect of things. It's definitely the toughest thing. But it's doable. You and me both, because we're the same people. We're not great cooks. We don't really make good food. You know, we're both kind of lazy in that sense of, you know, of creating food for ourselves. But I think I do have this personality where, you know, I was able to break off from Christianity because I have this personality of, you know, staying true to what I think is correct, after all the evidence has been weighed in. That's really the important thing for me. I am open to new concepts. I'm open to changing myself in order to fit what I think is the truth. Truth is important, I think, more than what's comfortable. Yeah, sure, if I continue to eat meat, whatever is comfortable, it's more convenient for my life to be that way. But it totally goes against my ideals, my values, my ethical values, goes against my moral compass. You know, it's the Bible started doing that for me, and that's why I had to break from it. Christianity was going against my moral compass. I had to break from it because I wanted to stay true to my value system. And veganism sort of ended up being an extension of that. I think it's one of the things that I'm currently most proud of, if anything, because I felt like the more I grew up, the older I became, the more mediocre, the less awesome I became in my idea. I guess I have a very rose-tinted view of my younger versions of myself. I see the 10-year-old version of me, and I think he's a brilliant kid as compared to me. But if there's anything that I, you know, would like to say, like, it's just that I'm, you know, after March 29th, 2010, I turned vegan, and that's one of the best thing I've done, one of the best decisions I've made with my life. I'm still really proud of it. You can do it. You're 21 years old. You can do it. It's quite a journey, but it's a journey that's worth it, you know. And it's something that you can feel really proud of, especially considering that you had no social support for almost a year. You've had to go on this journey by yourself alone. I mean, you've had some resources here and there, but actual personal support, you've had none. You actually had a lot of opposition, but you were able to overcome that. I was able to overcome that, and you become vegan, and it's such an amazing thing. And so I think that's one of the most positive recent turning points in my life. So yeah, cheers.